Share the World, Save the World, an essay by Eric Schechter. The world needs our help. It's in huge trouble and getting worse. Toxic spills are everywhere. We're about to fall off a cliff of global warming. And madmen are getting hold of guns, drones, nukes, and microbiology. And our economic system is crazy. It transforms rising productivity into rising unemployment. Markets favor whoever is in a better bargaining position, so the rich get richer and power becomes concentrated. And that's all while the system is doing what it's supposed to do, while it is honest, and it can't be kept honest. The market rewards greed and apathy. Power corrupts. Prisons are filled for profit. Bipartisan lies start awful wars for profit. The ecosystem is privatized and carelessly poisoned for profit, and it's dying. Some people blame our troubles on the personal moral failure of a few greedy plutocrats, but that's just a symptom. The root problem is the culture of separateness that is inside all of us. It's inherent in the so-called American dream, the seemingly harmless middle-class life to which we've all aspired. You keep your stuff in your house, and I keep my stuff in my house, and we see our lives as separate. Your well-being doesn't seem dependent on mine, and vice versa, and we don't notice we've made the world a lot less caring. We're taught competition, not cooperation, and we mistake money and power for meaning and happiness. No wonder bullying is widespread, and our society is hooked on antidepressants. And all of this can't be fixed by reforms, and our destruction can't be averted by compromises, because the problems keep accelerating as information grows. That genie can't be put back into its bottle. We'll only be saved by a culture of empathy, one big family with no one left behind and no one wanting to hurt another. And that's not just survival, that's utopia. That's a change so big that some people will call it the rapture. In fact, it goes back further than the Bible. For 10,000 years we've hoarded and fought, and now it's hard to imagine any other way of life. But for 100,000 years before that, we lived cooperatively, sharing everything of importance, and we still have that inside us. We need to find it again, and soon. Imagine all the people sharing all the world, John Lennon sang, and now I'm singing that too. Some people mock me because I haven't given away all my own possessions. But if I did, I'd just be one more homeless person. The wars and ecocide would continue. No, sharing isn't a one-person job. We need to get to know one another and figure out this culture change together. We're all needed on the planning committee.